Hello students, once again I am here with the same chapter, square and square root. In the previous class we have discussed about the division method, so how we find the square root using division method, and I gave you some homeworks also. So students, today we are doing the same thing but little bit in different way. Students, I have written one question. This question I have taken from your textbook. It is given that find the number of digits in the square root of 64, square root of 144, square root of 4489, square root of 27225. So it means what? What does it mean actually? When I take the square root of this number, how many digits I will get? First of all, let me show you this one. If I take the square root of 64, on taking square root, how much? 8 into 8, 64 is equal to 8. That means one digit. Square root of 64, how many digit I am getting? One digit. Square root of 144, 144, how many digit I will get, students? 12 multiplied by 12 is equal to 1. That means I am getting two digit. So now here, how many digit I will get? 4, 4, 8, 9. See students, in this type of sum, no need to find the square root. You just see, if I draw a bar over here, how many bar is there? One bar. One bar. That's why I'll get one digit. So now if I make it pair from right hand side, this will make one pair, this will make one pair. So how many bars are there? Two bars are there. That's why this will be two digit. And another thing, here also you can see how many bars. This is one pair, this is another pair. Number of bar is two. That means if I take the square root of this number, I will get two digit. I will get two digits. See over here, student. If I take the square root, then if I do it the division method, I will give bar. So now this is 44. What I will do? 6. We can write 6. 6 is 36. We cannot write 7. 6 is 42. 6. 6 is 36. I have already said it should be a square number. It should be a square number. 6, 6 are 36. Now I will subtract this. How much I will get over 14? 8. So then I'll copy this pair 89. I'll copy over 89. Then what will I do now? I will double this 6. That means 6 is there plus 6 I will do. That is 12. Then I will divide this one. By what I will divide? Here in ones place there is 3. So in on multiplying which two digit, I will get 9 in ones place. Let me check it out. If I multiply 3 multiply by 3, I will get 9 in ones place. If I multiply 7 into 7 is equal to, I will get 49. That means 9 in ones place. Either I will put 3 or 7. First let me put 3. 3. So now I will multiply 3 into 123. 123 multiplied by 3. 963. 369. It is not divisible. Now let me put 7 over here now. 7 7s are 49. 9 is in ones place. I will put 7 over here. I will put 7. Here also I will put 7. Now 127 multiplied by 7. 7 7s are 49. Carry 4. 7 2s are 14. 4. 18. 8. Carry 1. 7 1s are 7 plus 1. 8. That means 8, 8, 9. So 0. So how many digit I got? That means square root of 4, 4, 8, 9 is equal to 67. That means two digit number. So why two digit number? Because there are two bars are there, you see. That's a two digit. Here how many bar will be there? That means how can, first of all, always form a pair from right hand side. This is one pair. This is one pair and this doesn't form a pair. Let it be like this. How many bars are there? 1, 2, 3. That means if I do square root, I will get a 3 digit number. I will get here 3 digit number. Remember, student. I will get 3 digit number. No need to do this type of simplification. You just put the number of bars. You just count the number of bars. How many bars is there? 1. Square root of this number is 1 digit. How many bars is there? 2. Square root of this number is 2 digit. How many bars are there? 2. I will get the square root 2 digit number. How many bars are there? 1, 2, 3. I will get the square root 3-digit number. So hope, student, you have understood this. These all example I took from the from your textbook, students. Now let us go to some other topic, students. Now, students, if I find the square root of use division method to find the square root of 6.25. Suppose I ask you to find the square root of this number, the decimal number. Now we will learning square root, that means of this decimal. We are finding the square root of decimal. Now 6.25. Say, students, how will I find the square root of this 6.25? Same method, students. I say that we have to use the division method. So same process I will use, student. See, 6.25, I'll pair number from right hand side. This forms a pair, this doesn't form a pair, let it be like this. Then I'll divide. So by what number I will divide? 2 to the 4. So now I'll subtract 6 minus 4 2. Now what will I do? I cannot copy this 25 directly. What will I do now? I have to shift this decimal. I have to shift this decimal to this direction. Here. It means what? Until and unless you don't shift the decimal, this pair you cannot copy over here. Because this decimal doesn't allow you to copy this 25, remember. You can think in that way. This decimal doesn't allow this 25 to copy over here. You have to shift this decimal over here. Point. This decimal I have written over here. Now you can shift 25. Now this 2, double it, 4. So now what will I do? Since there is 5 in one space, I'll write 5 here. I'll write 5 here also. Now 5 multiply by 45. See, 45 multiply by 5. 5 carry 2. 5 4s are 20 plus 2. 22. See, 2 2 5. If I do subtract, I'll get 0. It means I've crossed it over there. So root over 6.25 is equal to how much I got? Is equal to 2.5. this is the way we find the square root of a decimal number. So I'll give you one or two more examples, student. Let me give one more example. So from your same exercise, question number 3, I am taking one more example. See, student, this example I have taken over here now. Suppose I have taken this one, 51.84. You have to find the square root of this number. So this time I took, previously I took 3-digit number, but here I took 4 digits are there. So I have to find the square root of this number. So what will I do, students? First of all, as we did in the previous class, I will pair. One pair, two pair. Then what will I do, students? I will divide this 51. So how will I divide? We always divide it by a square number. 7, 7's a 49. Now if I subtract it, I'll get 2. See, now can we copy 84? At present, we cannot copy this 84. So what we have to do? We have to shift this decimal over here. See, after this decimal, I shift this decimal over here. Now you can copy, because this decimal doesn't allow to copy this 84 until and unless you remove the decimal. First you have to remove the decimal to this position, shift this decimal to this position. Now you'll copy 84. Now I'll copy 84. So students, now what will I do? As we did in the previous class, now I will double this. That means 7, I'll make it 14. 1, 4, 14. So now 4 is in ones place. So on multiplying which two digits, I will get 4 in ones place, my students. 2 multiplied by 2 is equal to 4. Then 8 multiplied by 8 is equal to 64. See, on multiplying both the two, I am getting 4 in ones place. On multiplying 8 into 8, I am getting 4 in ones place. So what will I put over here now? First, let me try with 2, students. Once you get, you are clear with the, once you are thorough with this method, directly you can put the right answer. Now if I multiply 142 multiply by 2, how much I'll get? 2 2's are 4, 2 4's are 8, 2 1's are 2, 284. Say students, when I multiply 2, I put 2 over here, when I multiply 142 multiply by 2, how much I'll get? 284. So 284. So square root of 5, 1.84 is equal to, students, how much I'll get? 7.20 answer. See students, you have understood this type of sums. There is one more method by converting it into 100. That method I am not going to explain you, because if I explain you both the methods, you will get confused with it. So that's why I have explained these two type of sums. Decimal, the how to find the square root using the decimal. That means decimal sums, how we'll find the square root. So students, hope you have understood this one. So try to do the homework. Whichever homework I'll give you, I try to do the homework and go through the video 2-3 times. If you have any doubts regarding this, you please let me know. I'll try to make it clear. So students, you please see the solution once. 51.84. Then see 51.80, root over 51.484 is equal to 7.2 is your answer. Hope you students, you have understood this. So thank you and have a nice day ahead.